to setups. Now, Gears of War, and the matches are decided by a lot of small battles. Third person. Essentially taking on waves of enemies with your teammates. Decided over time. Different locations you have to be good at. Different weapons. You have to shoot for each other. And when you have the chance, set up with each other to cover the angles which you are weak at. And to fight it to the last stand with your brothers to the end. This is setups with GC Stunt for my team. And last time we were here, we were going over impact. And last time we were working on initial and impact. And that initial, you know, you can watch in the previous, it wasn't fleshed out, but it was a good start. Now for this one, I want to go over a setup and how you hold a setup. So again, let's go with the cog. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the locust devils, the monsters of the game, the swarm, whatever you want to call them, for you new kids, over there on the west spawn. Now let's say we clash in the middle. We clash at cockpit, which is here. Let me put a layer here. Let's do a little circle. Oh, it's not streaming. Is it? I don't know. Let me check. If it's... It shouldn't be streaming. Let's see here. I think it's a mess up. Somehow it's working, so I won't question it. Alright. So back to impact. Now, here, I can actually change things up now since my monitor is working. There we go. Alright, so back to the topic. So we clash in the middle. Let's put here a circle. Let's say we had our initial here. This is where the bulk of the action's going down. We had the typical, you know, we meet and greeted right there in the middle. We have a teammate here on a T. Let's increase that size. We have one at T, one at control box desk, one at second window, one at pods. What's going on here? Huh. I don't know why Pods isn't showing up. Let's go back. Is it frozen? Alright. That's weird. So we have our initial. Let's say we win B. And there's two of us that survived over here. Make this look better. There we go. Two of us survived here. We're scattered. We're on high red. One of us survived down here for the initial. And one of us survived here. This is, I'm not even discussing how the battle went down. But let's say there's four of us alive off the rip. And we have the opportunity to win. How do we win? How do we set up so the enemy can't push back to us? Now the enemy team, they still have this ring. Let's say they still have A. So what do we do? What do our teammates do at cockpit? How do they play this? Well, usually I would send us up here to the parking so we could spawn kill. But the thing is, I don't think we've earned that right to do that yet because we don't have the home base. The home base is still on, you know, it's contested. There's still enemies here. And if we send two of our teammates up here, our teammates down here that used to be at the cockpit, they're no longer interacting really with the teammates up here at the second tier. Let me back up. So instead of having our teammates rotate to their steps yet, I want the objective to be completed down here. So I would have their movement denoted by yellow. I would want them rotating up here to help the teammates down here win their battle. And the way I would win it is very simple, just a simple pinch, simple bait and switch, two and two. And in this time, or actually, we'll probably leave one here at the cockpit. So we're gonna fight the enemy, we're gonna push him back, we're gonna pinch him, we're gonna make him fight us. And let's say we win this over. Now, the way we set up, we kill him. Let's say we kill this enemy. He's a goner, poor guy. He's a goner. So now we have the chance to trip cap. And we have their base. So let me go back a few for you and me. So, a teammate here, during this whole debacle up here at their home base, he says, "Hey, there's two pushing me." It is paramount with the way I like to play this game. There's a formula. If you don't have numbers, you retreat and try to punish them for playing the hill. So, by the time the enemy are here, you have some recognition that they're coming. Let's say you planted a smoke, you hear a pop, you see him. By the time you see him at first, you don't stand your ground here to get bodied at the hill. You rotate back a few steps, back an area where they're gonna have to chase you on our territory, and in a place where you're safe, even if it's all the way back here. I don't care. You find a point where they eventually stop chasing you and play the objective. If they don't play the objective and they continuously chase you, we denote their movement by red. If they chase you past the objective all the way up to here and they continue to try to fight you, excellent. That means we are definitely going to triple cap them because they don't know how to play the objective. But eventually, any team with some type of brain, they will cap that objective. And the good thing is, if you retreat up to here, you can give us some lancer shots, something to punish them a little bit for trying to cap that. So, but if you died, let's say you die in here like you're not supposed to do. Let's say you fought the 2v1 and you died. Now we have two enemies bunkered down in here in an area which is all CQC, close quarter combat. We have an enemy here. We could have an enemy, you know, he capped and now he's camping where you once were. And we have an enemy up here camping our steps, and it's just not looking nice for us because now every time we rotate from basically since you died, now you rotate and you're coming down here, you don't know where the enemy is, so you're paranoid. You could be running, rushing, and he could flank you at any one of these points where it's around this cover. Flank you here, flank you here, flank you here, flank you here. Anywhere along here is close enough for nearly a one-shot kill with a shotgun. So it's paramount you retreat back just so you can keep eyes on those enemies that, you know, now playing this area. But let's say you did your job, right? You did your job, you stayed alive, and you didn't play the 1v1 or 2v1, or 1v2, I mean. And you rotated back here. Tool option, zoom out. Okay. Brushers. Let's say you rotated to your second window. Now, with the two enemies here, it's okay if the two enemies here, because the good thing is you have your teammates here. And if our teammates are set up in their home hill here, and now this teammate can rotate back, I kind of want to keep this setup at A. I believe our two teammates. it's a tough scenario. So if there are two teammates here, I mean two enemies in here, let's say one's camping here, one's camping on steps. If I send out teammate back here, right, and he's moving from here to here, he sees there's an enemy here, and these two teammates are in communication, cahoots together, to make this a battle that I would want to fight, I would need my teammate from here to rotate back here. Okay? Just to make this a 3v2 advantage. I don't like necessarily taking battles that are not in our favor. I'm greedy like that. And if I send my teammate back here, I'm leaving my one teammate here. Now the scenarios are reversed. We, us three up here, which are now on this, on there, on the first lane of the map. You can see here the lanes as top lane, middle lane, and then bottom lane. Now, since all three of us are basically trying to fight for this B at the top lane, it's important for us to play by the books. Bait and switch, pinching, playing the objective versus playing the enemies, avoiding shotgun fights, keeping the team fire, focus fire, to win that area. Now, if we eliminate these two and win this base back, this teammate up here is probably getting pushed by enemies because they're on respawn. So they're rotating to him. They're coming in. Three deep. Now, Fool, which a lot of people are because we're egotistical, we want to fight, we want to defend this hill, we want to put up our line, we don't want to be bouncing, we want to be, you know, one shot kill. You can see it like, oh, there's one here, you corner camp him, you hit a shot, you wall bounce, and then you die. Now, that sucks for us, because now they're going to take away our entire bottom lane. After that, they will most definitely rotate to our base. And now they have control of the bottom lane, and we have control of top lane, and that's no good, because that's nobody's map control. So let's go back. Alright. So, let's say you were a good teammate. And you said, wow, I have three enemies approaching. What's the formula? The formula is, if it's a 1v1, you play the neutral hill. Meaning you keep it contested, you stay away from death range, you play it smart. If you have numbers, you play the hill and secondly kill the enemies. And lastly, if it's a number disadvantage, you rotate out and try to punish them for capping the hill. But the thing is, it's a home hill. So it's hard to shoot into the hill, unless you rotate here. But I would want you, my teammate, probably to rotate back between here and go to your home hill. And so that allows us, who are winners at B, to have something to work with. We have your angle shooting across from here to here, shooting across from here to here, and just to call things out where they're rotating. Now, if they're pushing pods hard, we have two options. We can meet him here, like a linebacker line, like one here, one here, one here. Just get ready to shoot at them, at the enemies as they're coming in here. We can swap hills. We can say, okay, they're pushing three here. That means it's going to be a 3v3, so let's us three rotate one here, send one to second window, and send the last one to keep them at pods. Now, if you look at the setup we have, if we rotate like that, we have one at second window, one at table, pods, one on second tier, And 1, 2, 3. You know, one playing over here. That big door, their big door. This is where rotations come in. We don't always need to meet them face smack on in these tight little areas, which we would have to meet them. You know, we can do that. I don't want to do that because that makes it's essentially a 50-50. Because we don't. The only time we. I'll discuss that in a minute. But so by us rotating, yeah, we're gonna give this hill up again. But again, our teammates who are here, here, and here have the ability to rotate here, back in the base, and resecure their A home lanes. So we're basically playing bottom lanes again. So it's just that rotation that needs to occur based on the formula. And if you rotate appropriately, no teammates are dying, you will continue to have hill advantage, and you'll be able to put the enemy in, you'll be controlling the enemy. Now, the best case scenario is if we win B, are able to set up on their lanes up here, and also simultaneously win A and set up on their lanes here for the trip cap. This is how a trip cap looks, because the enemy loses their spawn protection as they approach here, so he's getting pinched up nasty as soon as he approaches this area. And the enemies, as soon as they, you know, start shuffling down into here, they're getting cross-lancered. And if they push one section, this guy just needs to fall back, and this guy needs to retain his position. And but if any type of focus fire with any type of enemy team who's respawns, they didn't wait for everyone to group up, and they don't really have a choice since we're going for the trip cap. They're going to be coming in one by one, smoking it out, but they're going to be getting lancered. That's pretty much covers a little bit of rotations, that covers setups, and the rotations are very important because it helps you follow the formula, it makes the time dead low, and it improves overall teamwork. Yeah, that's how I would do that. Thank you for watching.